करने का निर्णय लिया है। संबंधों को इस मुकाम तक लाने में राष्ट्रपति ट्रंप का अमूल्य योगदान रहा है। फ्रेंड्स, आज हमारी चर्चा में हमने इस पार्टनरशिप के हर अहम पहलू पर सकारात्मक विचार किया, चाहे वो डिफेंस एंड सिक्योरिटी हो, एनर्जी स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप हो, टेक्नोलॉजी कोऑपरेशन हो, ग्लोबल कनेक्टिविटी हो, ट्रेड रिलेशंस हो या फिर पीपल टू पीपल टाइज। भारत और अमेरिका के बीच बढ़ता रक्षा और सुरक्षा सहयोग हमारी स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप का एक बहुत अहम हिस्सा है। अत्याधुनिक रक्षा उपकरण व प्लेटफॉर्म पर सहयोग से भारत की डिफेंस क्षमता में बढ़ोतरी हुई है। हमारे डिफेंस मैन्युफैक्चरर्स एक दूसरे की सप्लाई चेन्स का हिस्सा बन रहे हैं। भारतीय फोर्सेस आज सबसे अधिक ट्रेनिंग एक्सरसाइजेज यूएसए के फोर्सेस के साथ कर रही है। पिछले कुछ सालों में हमारी सेनाओं के बीच इंटर ऑपरेबिलिटी में अनप्रेसिडेंटेड वृद्धि हुई है। फ्रेंड्स, इसी तरह हम अपने होमलैंड्स की सुरक्षा और अंतर्राष्ट्रीय अपराध से लड़ने के लिए भी सहयोग बढ़ा रहे हैं। आज होमलैंड सिक्योरिटी पर हुए निर्णय से इस सहयोग को और बल मिलेगा। आतंक के समर्थकों को जिम्मेदार ठहराने के लिए आज हमने अपने प्रयासों को और बढ़ाने का निश्चय किया है। प्रेसिडेंट ट्रंप ने ड्रग्स और ओपियोइड क्राइसिस से लड़ाई को प्राथमिकता दी है। आज हमारे बीच ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग, नार्को टेररिज्म और ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम जैसी गंभीर समस्याओं के बारे में एक नए मैकेनिज्म पर भी सहमति हुई है। फ्रेंड्स, कुछ ही समय पहले स्थापित हमारी स्ट्रेटेजिक एनर्जी पार्टनरशिप सुदृढ़ होती जा रही है और इस क्षेत्र में आपसी निवेश बढ़ा है। तेल और गैस के लिए अमेरिका भारत का एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण स्रोत बन गया है। पिछले चार वर्षों में हमारा कुल एनर्जी व्यापार करीब 20 बिलियन डॉलर रहा है। रिन्यूएबल हो या न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी, हमारे कोऑपरेशन को नई ऊर्जा मिल रही है। फ्रेंड्स, इसी तरह इंडस्ट्री 4.0 और 21st सेंचुरी की अन्य उभरती टेक्नोलॉजीज, उस पर भी इंडिया यूएस पार्टनरशिप इनोवेशन और एंटरप्राइज के नए मुकाम स्थापित कर रही है। भारतीय प्रोफेशनल्स के टैलेंट ने अमेरिकी कंपनीज की टेक्नोलॉजी लीडरशिप को मजबूत किया है। फ्रेंड्स, भारत और अमेरिका आर्थिक क्षेत्र में ओपननेस और फेयर एंड बैलेंस्ड ट्रेड के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है। पिछले तीन वर्षों में हमारे द्विपक्षीय व्यापार में डबल डिजिट ग्रोथ हुई है और वह ज्यादा संतुलित भी हुआ है। अगर एनर्जी, सिविल एयरक्राफ्ट्स, डिफेंस और हायर एजुकेशन ले तो पिछले चार पांच सालों में सिर्फ इन चार सेक्टर्स ने ही भारत अमेरिका के आर्थिक संबंधों में लगभग 70 बिलियन डॉलर्स का योगदान किया है। इसमें से काफी कुछ राष्ट्रपति ट्रंप की नीतियों और फैसलों के कारण संभव हुआ है। मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आने वाले समय में यह आंकड़ा काफी बढ़ जाएगा। जहां तक बायलेटरल ट्रेड का सवाल है, हमारे कॉमर्स मिनिस्टर्स के बीच सकारात्मक वार्ताएं हुई हैं। राष्ट्रपति ट्रंप और मैं आज सहमत हुए हैं कि हमारे कॉमर्स मिनिस्टर के बीच जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग बनी है उसे हमारी टीम्स लीगल रूप दें। हम एक बड़ी ट्रेड डील के लिए नेगोशिएशन शुरू करने पर भी सहमत हुए हैं। हमें आशा है कि आपसी हित में इसके अच्छे परिणाम निकलेंगे। फ्रेंड्स, वैश्विक स्तर पर भारत और अमेरिका का सहयोग हमारे समान लोकतांत्रिक मूल्यों और उद्देश्यों पर आधारित है, खासकर इंडो पैसिफिक और ग्लोबल कॉमन्स में रूल बेस्ड इंटरनेशनल ऑर्डर के लिए यह सहयोग विशेष महत्व रखता है। हम दोनों देश विश्व में कनेक्टिविटी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के विकास में सस्टेनेबल एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट फाइनेंसिंग के महत्व पर सहमत है। हमारा यह आपसी तालमेल एक दूसरे के ही नहीं बल्कि विश्व के हित में है। फ्रेंड्स, भारत और अमेरिका की स्पेशल मित्रता की सबसे महत्वपूर्ण नींव हमारे पीपल टू पीपल रिलेशंस हैं। चाहे वो प्रोफेशनल्स हो या स्टूडेंट्स, यूएसए में इंडियन डायस्पोरा का इसमें सबसे बड़ा योगदान रहा है। भारत के ये एम्बेसडर्स ना सिर्फ अपने टैलेंट और परिश्रम से यूएसए की अर्थव्यवस्था में कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं बल्कि अपने डेमोक्रेटिक वैल्यूज और समृद्ध कल्चर से अमेरिकन सोसाइटी को भी एनरिच कर रहे हैं। मैंने राष्ट्रपति ट्रंप से अनुरोध किया है कि हमारे प्रोफेशनल्स के सोशल सिक्योरिटी कंट्रीब्यूशन पर टोटलाइजेशन एग्रीमेंट को दोनों पक्ष चर्चा आगे बढ़ाएं। यह आपसी हित में होगा। फ्रेंड्स, इन सभी आयामों में हमारे रिश्तों को और मजबूत बनाने में राष्ट्रपति ट्रंप की यह यात्रा ने ऐतिहासिक भूमिका निभाई है। एक बार फिर मैं प्रेसिडेंट ट्रंप को भारत आने के लिए और भारत अमेरिका संबंधों को नई ऊंचाई पर पहुंचाने के लिए हार्दिक धन्यवाद देता हूं। थैंक यू।
Well, thank you very much. And Prime Minister Modi, this has been a very special visit. Unforgettable, extraordinary. What can you say? Very, very wonderful to be with you. Thank you very much. And Melania and I have been awed by the majesty of India and the exceptional kindness and generosity of the Indian people. We'll always remember the magnificent welcome the citizens of your home state showed us upon arrival. It was a profound expression of strength and of real love. Really, it was love. And I think everybody saw that. Everybody witnessed that for themselves. The First Lady and I also reflected on the memory of Mahatma Gandhi at his ashram. And this morning in Delhi, we laid a wreath in his honor. We visited one of your nation's most stunning cultural treasures, the world-famous Taj Mahal. And we look forward to continuing our visit tonight during a wonderful state banquet with President Kovind at the Presidential Palace. I know Prime Minister Modi will agree that this has been a very productive visit for both of our countries. Earlier today, we expanded our defense cooperation with agreements for India to purchase more than $3 billion of advanced American military equipment, including Apache and MH-60 Romeo helicopters, the finest in the world. These deals will enhance our joint defense capabilities as our militaries continue to train and operate side by side. In our discussions, Prime Minister Modi and I affirmed our two countries' commitment to protecting our citizens from radical Islamic terrorism. In this effort, the United States is also working productively with Pakistan to confront terrorists who operate on its soil. Together, the Prime Minister and I are revitalizing the Quad Initiative with the United States, India, Australia, and Japan. Since I took office, we have held the first Quad ministerial meeting, I guess you would call it a meeting, but it seems like so much more than that, an expanded cooperation on counterterrorism, cybersecurity, and maritime security to ensure a free and open Indo-Pacific. As we deepen our partnership with India, we remember that our two countries have always been united by shared traditions of democracy and constitutions that protect freedom, individual rights, and the rule of law. During our visit, we discussed the importance of a secure 5G wireless network and the need for this emerging technology to be a tool for freedom, progress, prosperity, not to do anything where it could be even conceived as a conduit for suppression and censorship. To guarantee that the infrastructure of the future is built in a safe, transparent, and accountable manner, the United States is working with a range of partners, including Australia and Japan, to create the Blue Dot Network, a major initiative to ensure countries around the world to have access to private sector-led, sustainable, and trustworthy options for high-quality infrastructure development, and that's what's happening. Another major focus of my discussions with Prime Minister Modi is forging bilateral economic relationships that is fair and reciprocal. Our teams have made tremendous progress on a comprehensive trade agreement, and I'm optimistic we can reach a deal that will be of great importance to both countries. Since I took office, U.S. exports to India are up nearly 60%, and exports of high-quality American energy have grown by, thank you very much, 500%. That's great. As India grows, so do its energy needs. Yesterday, ExxonMobil signed a deal to improve India's natural gas distribution network so that the U.S. can export even more LNG to India. We are pleased to be joined by the chairman of ExxonMobil LNG Market Development, Alex Volkoff. Thank you, Alex, wherever you may be. Where is Alex? Is he here someplace? Alex, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Alex. And the CEO of Chart Energy and Chemicals, Jillian Ivanko. Thank you very much. Thank you both. Thank you, Jillian. Thank you very much. That's a big deal, Alex, right? Can you handle it? I think so, right? It's great. To further strengthen our economic ties, the United States is pleased to announce that the U.S. International Development Finance Corporation will be establishing a permanent presence right here. America is especially committed to working with India to improve development and empower women entrepreneurs. That is why my daughter Ivanka attended the Global Entrepreneurship Summit in Hyderabad to highlight women's economic empowerment. Ivanka, please, great job you've done. Thank you very much. Thank you. We have since launched the WGDP initiative, which is now spearheading projects supporting women in the economy from New Delhi to Kolkata. In our meetings with the Prime Minister, we discussed and agreed to create a counter-narcotics working group to confront the growing threat of illicit fentanyl and opioid production. We must rid our societies of these lethal, horrible poisons. We will rid our societies of these bad drugs that are pouring in. Prime Minister Modi, we have made tremendous advances for our people over the past 2 days, and working together, I know that our two nations will continue to achieve new breakthroughs, unlock new potential, and forge even brighter futures in the years ahead. We think we're at a point where our relationship is so special with India. It has never been as good as it is right now, and I think that's because the two leaders of each country.
A couple of really great days in India. Prime Minister Modi is a terrific man. He's a terrific leader. And we have a lot of things going in terms of product being purchased by India, be investing billions of dollars in our country. So that was the purpose of the trip also. We're all set for $3 billion worth of helicopters, the Apaches and various other types, in addition to other equipment. They're buying that. And they're buying a lot. They're going to be buying a lot. And they're also going to be buying a lot of our energy, all forms of our energy, because they need energy. And we have more than anybody. We're number one in the world now in energy. So that's going to be very exciting. But I thought it was a great 2 days. It was a fantastic 2 days. I'm going to be not at all controversial because I don't want to blow the 2 days plus 2 days of travel on one answer.
While you've been here in the country, in the capital, northeast part of Delhi, there have been violent clashes. Police have been killed, some demonstrators, 9 deaths so far, we hear, and about 100 plus injured. What did Prime Minister Modi say to you about this amended citizenship law? And how concerned are you about this kind of religious violence in India?
So we did talk about religious freedom, and I will say that the Prime Minister was incredible on what he told me. He wants people to have religious freedom, and very strongly, and he said that in India they have worked very hard to have great and open religious freedom. And if you look back and look at what's going on relative to other places especially, but they have really worked hard on religious freedom. I asked that question in front of a very large group of people today, and he talked about it. We talked about it for a long time, and I really believe that's what he wants. As far as the individual attack, I heard about it, but I didn't discuss that with him. That's up to India.
You know, India's concern is with neighborhood, and you and Prime Minister Modi tell that you are very good friends. What is your strategy about terrorism that is coming out from Pakistan to India? Because we had been suffering from this type of terrorism for the last 20 years or so. What is your strategy? What are you going to do?
We talked a lot about Pakistan. I have a very good relationship with Prime Minister Khan, very good. We talked about it today at length, actually, and Prime Minister Modi. And it's no question it's a problem, but it's a problem they're working on it. India is, you know, it's a brave nation too. There's no pullback from India. And we just hope, and I said, I'll help, I'll do whatever I have to do if I can do that, because my relationship with both gentlemen is so good. But there has been difficulty in Pakistan, and we're seeing what we can do about it. Anything I can do to mediate, anything I can do to help, I would do. They're working on Kashmir. Kashmir has been a thorn in a lot of people's sides for a long time. And there are two sides to every story, but they've been working on that very hard. We discussed it at great length, terrorism. And I think we have some very good ideas. He's very, very strongly against terrorism. I'll tell you, Prime Minister Modi is a very religious man, as you know. He's a very calm man, but he's actually a very